To the banking sector now, Philippine lenders see improved asset quality in November. Data from the Banco Central showed the gross non-performing loan ratio of the industry was down to its lowest in 2 months. The measure of banking health slightly eased to 3.41% in the said month from the 3.44% in October. Bad loans or defaulted borrowings in the said period, though, climbed to 454 billion pesos from the 449 billion. Philippine factory output in the Philippines expanded in November. Data from the Philippine Statistics Bureau show the volume of production index registered a year-on-year increase of 1.9% in the said month. That growth rate is higher than October's 1.5%, but significantly lower than last year's 6.4%. The PSA points to the contributions of top three industry divisions: manufacture of beverages, manufacture of transport equipment, and manufacture of chemical and chemical products for the increase. Corporate stories now. The Ayala Group confirms a report that Japan's Mitsubishi Corporation is unloading shares in the conglomerate. The Tokyo trading giant is apparently offering over 8 million shares of Ayala at a share price of 647 pesos apiece. Ayala Corp says, though, that the potential $100 million, which Mitsubishi looks to generate from the undertaking, is but an estimate. Meanwhile, the MCI staying cautiously optimistic for its prospects this year. The Kunsunhi-led conglomerate attributes that outlook to the combined effects of cooling inflation, stabilizing interest rates, as well as China's economic slowdown and the modest growth in the local energy market. The firm also sees the expected rate cuts as encouraging economic activities and helping its performance this year. The MCI says it weathered headwinds in 2023 and even managed to post all-time high coal shipments and off-grid energy sales. Its nickel mine in Zamboanga also shipped 1.68 million wet metric tons of nickel ore in the said year. The National Bureau of Investigation and GCash team up to launch a probe on scams involving the e-wallet platform. For more on this story, let's bring in our correspondent, Jackie Pascuala. Jackie?
Hi, good afternoon, Denise. The National Bureau of Investigation has formally sealed a partnership with e-wallet firm GCash to work together in the investigation of various online scams. A memorandum of agreement signing event was held in Taguig early today. NBI Director Medardo de Lemo said criminal behaviors have changed and crimes are now online. He added that partnerships with fintech companies are crucial to investigate crimes, many of which affect e-wallet accounts. Renren Reyes, President and CEO of GXchange Inc., or that's GCash, said that the partnership would help speed up investigations as the NBI can seek help from GCash if GCash accounts are involved in a crime, and GCash too may seek assistance of the NBI. Aside from helping in the investigation, both parties will also share information or data on the latest trends in cybercrime to help prevent the spread of such incidents or cases. Both the NBI and GCash urge the public to file a formal complaint or police report before they can act on the cases. The NBI admits, though, they need to hire more cyber investigators with the expected increase in the number of complaints. The NBI director asserted that the face of criminal behavior has changed, and now they will need to train more personnel and purchase equipment to intensify the investigation into cyber crimes. And that's the latest. Denise, back to you.
Jackie Pascual with that story. Thanks, Jackie. The Philippine Senate begins its hearings into the massive power outage that hit Panay Island last week. Senate Energy Committee Chairman Rafi Tulfo said the probe seeks to determine the cause of the outage and hold those accountable. Senator Risa Ontiveros, who filed a resolution calling for the investigation, said it may be time to review the legislative franchise of the National Grid Corporation.
In our previous hearings, Mr. Chair, I also have called out NGCP for its repeated failure to fulfill its obligations to the country, even as it rakes in billions in profits for its shareholders. Hindi pa rin natutugunan ang issue ng national security dahil sa 40% ownership ng China sa NGCP.
mahiya na lang tayo sa mga tao na naghirap at sa mga taong bayad ng bayad ng napakamahal na kuryente. They really deserve better. Hindi pwedeng sorry na lang parati. Damage has been done and reparations need to be made.
Local leaders of Panay Island were present at the hearing. Iloilo City Mayor Jerry Treñas did not mince words to air his constituents' dismay over the widespread blackouts. Mayor Treñas said the local economy suffered a 2 billion peso loss in the four-day outage.
We are looking for accountabilities. We are not going to sit down this time and just listen to all these inquiries. The last time this happened in April of 2023, nothing happened. No one was held accountable. Unfortunately, some of our friends in the legislature were trying to help defend those who are guilty. This time, we will not allow those people who are responsible to get away with this. How can this four-day blackout, brownout happen in a country that is supposed to be one of the most developing countries in the ASEAN?
Social media giant Meta will hide more content from teens on Instagram and Facebook. This as it faces intense regulatory pressure from around the world to protect children from harmful content. Meta said all teens will now be placed into the most restrictive content control settings on the apps. Additional search terms will also be limited on Instagram. These moves will make it more difficult for teens to come across sensitive content such as suicide, self-harm, and eating disorders. Meta is under pressure both in the U.S. and Europe over allegations its apps are addictive and fuel a youth mental health crisis.